A blow for the first Russian soldier to stand trial in a Ukrainian court since the start of the invasion.
The court found Vadim Shishimarin guilty.
21-year-old Vadim Shishimarin, sentenced by a civilian court to life in jail for killing an unarmed civilian in a village in northeastern Ukraine, 4 days after Russia invaded the country.
Today, more than 13,000 cases only about war crimes. And now we have first sentence. What? It's not enough. It's only beginning. It means that these 3 months, our investigators and prosecutors properly have done their job.
Shishimarin confessed to killing the man in court last week, but said he'd been under intense pressure. A fellow soldier confirmed Shishimarin was obeying orders and had no choice but to fire the fatal shot. His lawyer says he'll file an appeal.
I believe and continue to believe that a person who carried out an order cannot be convicted under this article.
The judge said because the crime broke international law, was, quote, against peace, security and humanity, the court couldn't impose a shorter sentence.
This will be a good example for other occupiers who may not yet be on our territory but are planning to come, or those who are here now and plan to stay and fight.
On Friday, Shishimarin had made a final plea for clemency.
I'm sorry and I sincerely repent. I was nervous the moment it happened. I didn't want to kill, but it happened and I do not deny it.
The Kremlin says it's concerned about Shishimarin and will seek ways to assist him. Melissa Bell, CNN, Kyiv.
With us now for more on the latest developments from Ukraine is Lieutenant General Mark Hertling, a CNN military analyst and former Army Commanding General for Europe and 7th Army. General Hertling, good to have you back.
It's great to be with you, John, as always.
OK, well, now, the speed of this first war crimes trial in Ukraine, you know, from bringing charges to the sentencing, well, the fighting is actually still going on. It seems unprecedented. Could you see other future conflicts following this as an example? Well, at the same time, is there a risk here that Ukrainian soldiers in Russian custody could face similar treatment or worse, be tried on trumped-up or bogus charges?
Yes and yes. This has been a fast moving crime and judgment on this young soldier, this 21-year-old tanker, who admittedly shot a civilian, but also during his trial basically gave up his superior, saying that he was told to do that. Now, that's never a defense, but you can tell by his anxiety, his fear, you know, his concern about what might happen to him if he didn't do what he was told to do, is indicative of the way the Russian army is doing things. Will Ukraine have more of these trials? I think they will. They certainly have a very active group of people investigating war crimes, everything from murder to rape to sexual assault, all the things that you see associated with the kind of conflict we're seeing with the Russian troopers. And that doesn't even start to consider the indiscriminate bombing of cities and the use of civilians as targets. So, yeah, I think you're going to see more of the Ukrainian ministries executing these war crimes, trying to put Russian soldiers on trial, perhaps even trying them in absentia. But as you just said, it could be challenging for the Ukrainians as well, because we have these hundreds of fighters coming out of the Azovstal steel plant in Mariupol who are now under Russian control, and there are indicators that Russia is not going to treat them as prisoners of war, which they should be treated. They're uniformed soldiers, but instead war criminals. And will they trump up charges to go against them? So I think we're in a very dangerous and precarious position right now, John.